you. Thank you all so much for coming in so quietly. Well, pretty quietly. But thank you for not touching the stuff in the middle of your table. I didn't even have to tell you not to, but you can not do. That was very good. Please don't touch anything in the middle of the table until I tell you to. And I realize I put one paper on the wrong table. I'll move it over here when we're ready. No problem. Your stuff's just over there.
Go get it.
Thank you.
Stuff to it, but I'm not going to get into that yet. That'll be next. So we're going to
this today. I'm just going to show you real quick how to do it because I want to make sure you have plenty of time. So in the middle of your table, don't touch them yet, you have the basket of pencils.
Yep.
You'll take a pencil. There's some things that artists and builders and construction people use called a plumb line. The plumb line is a line that just drops straight down through something. So we're going to use a plumb line with this pencil to start our drawing so that you don't just have to put things on the paper not knowing what you're going to do. So a plumb line is just a line that goes straight through something. So if you're going to map out on here where you want to put your tree, I don't want you to draw the whole tree. That'll take way too long because you need as much time as you can to actually put paint on. So instead of drawing both sides of the tree, you're just going to do a plumb line. Just draw one line. I know you can't see it. You'll be able to see it on your paper. Draw one line straight up the middle of the paper or wherever you want the middle of your tree to be and stop wherever you want the top of your tree to stop. So my plumb line on this one would have been about right here. Just draw one line, that's it. And then maybe for a couple of your first big branches, just draw one more plumb line, just one line right where the middle of that branch is. So I draw one out here, put a loop. Draw one over here, put another loop. You notice I'm painting all of the branches loopy and swirly. It kind of makes it exciting, like the tree is very alive and in every direction. So we're going to do that too. So I've got the middle of my trunk, the middle of three big branches, maybe throw a fourth one on there. That's all you really need to do with the pencil.
Wow.
You really want to have a lot of time to paint. This paint sometimes doesn't cover well. It depends. Especially on the black paper, it tends to be a little bit kind of streaky. And we want to try to make it look as solid as possible. If you're going to have a jar like this, you're sharing it between the two people. And you don't need water for this. You want this paint to be as thick as possible. So there's no water. Question?
Can it be a tree of death?
No, it is the tree of life. And so you're just going to dip your paint, your brush into the paint. Don't dip it so far down that the paint gets onto the metal of the brush. Try to keep it on just the bristles. Otherwise, brushes get ruined. Question?
What is the two colors on blue and purple?
I don't see two colors.
It's just shade.
It is. The paper kind of curled up a little, so you're probably just seeing shadows. So then you're just going to start and just apply the paint. And I would even take the paint and just follow those first plumb lines that you made with the pencil, just so you know where you're going before you start making pictures. So I've got one over here, made a big loop, one up here with a big loop, and you're going to cover this all up again, so this does not have to look like the perfect part. You're going to go back
another plumb line.
So there. That's all the plumb lines that I made with my pencil. I just went over them with paint so I can see them better. And then you go back through and you start filling in and making them thicker and bigger. You want a nice big trunk on your tree. It's the tree of life. It's an important tree. It's sustaining the life of people in the garden or wherever your tree of life might be. And then you're just going to let it branch off into the branches and make sure to just fill it all in. And this paint dries pretty quick. So you might find that you've got spots that are not covering very well, like you can see a lot of black paper through there. If it's just not covering well because the paint's just moving around, let it dry for a few minutes, work on something over here. Once it's dry, come back and cover it up again, and it should cover this one. Okay? You're going to get one big brush and one little brush. Everybody will have one of each at their table. I want you to use this big brush for as long as you can. Because if you try painting your whole tree with a little tiny brush, you're going to be here for 3 days. Alright? So, on this one that I painted over here, I did this whole part, all of these, every one of these branches I did with this big brush. The only thing I did with this little brush was these four little tiny ones. All of this was done with the big brush. I know you can do it if you are careful. If you just start going crazy. I don't want these to look that messy. I want you to try to keep them pretty clean. Yeah.
Is there a rule to mention that number of
branches?
No, there's no set number of branches. Just try to fill up as much space as possible. And I recommend doing like one branch on one side, one on the other, working your way up. Because if you spend all your time just working on this side and then run out of time, then you'll just have a big black side of paper. So try to keep going back and forth across your paper so that at least you have a couple branches on each side. And then I think you'll be alright.
Equality.
Alright, go ahead and pass off the pencils. That's all you need right now. Do some fun lines.
Yeah, there's this map that you're going to do.
Thank you. I'm going to get white. Did he just sing that?
He did a Tennessee girl.